Hi guys, this is Matai the Dead, doing another review, and this time it's for a film that I'd known about for about a year or so. I was told about this film from Robin Boogie, who, if you've been subscribed to my channel for long, I always seem to talk about Robin Boogie, and he did an article, or more of a review, in CinemaSewer about this film, and it piqued my interest then, but for some reason I never got round to finding a copy of it. I mean, you can't buy this on DVD, it's not being released on DVD yet, so you could only either watch it on like a VHS, I think, and also a download online, which that's what I've done. Which a lot of people are rarely, we shouldn't download films. Well, if you can't buy the film, and no one's making money from those films anyway, what's the problem with you downloading it? I mean, even if I download a film that's on DVD, chances are I'll buy the DVD afterwards. But yeah, the only way you can really watch this is by tracking down a VHS or by watching it online. They did, however, show it on TCM in America, which is Turner's, I think it's Turner's Classic Movies, which we have in the UK, but they weren't showing it over here. And that's what got me into actually thinking, right, I'm going to watch this film, because a few people who I'm friends with on Facebook were mentioning this film again, like last week, and it reminded me to finally get around to watching it. And I am so glad I did, because this film is fantastic. I absolutely adore it. I can understand why it's got a cult following as well. And this film is awesome. And that film is, of course, Little Darlings from 1980. Directed by a guy named Ronald F. Maxwell, who didn't really do much in television or cinema. He did this, a few other films. Probably the most notable is The Parent Trap 2. But from what I've read, he's, very involved in writing plays and theatre and stuff, so most of his work has been done there. But again, that could be, not the case at all. But this is one of his films, and you wouldn't think that he hadn't had that many films to his credit, because this film is just brilliant. And it stars Tatum O'Neill, who was in films like Bad News Bears. She was in the remake of The Runaways, and also Paper Moon. And it also stars Christy McNichol, who was in the infamous White Dog, and also a couple of episodes of Starsky and Hutch, the original series. And again, their careers have been varied. I believe the last thing that Christy McNichol did for TV was in like 1998, whereas Tatum O'Neill is still doing stuff to this day. And she's been in, things like Sex and the City and stuff like that. Law and Order as well, which pretty much every actor or actress has been in Law and Order. But yeah, they star as the main two people. Two girls, two 15-year-old girls, who get sent to like a holiday camp, a summer camp, called, I think it's Little Wolf Camp, I can't remember. But basically they get sent there. They, after a while they get, started to talk with the other girls there, and the subject of virginity comes up, and it comes to light that both Tatum and Christie's character have yet to lose their virginity. So the other girls take it upon themselves to put a little bit of a wager on. And basically the whole premise of the film is Christie and Tatum basically trying to lose their virginity. And they, pick their sights. Christie's character goes for the mature camp counsellor. He's not camp, he's, the camp counsellor. And Tatum goes for the rebel like kid, who is actually played by a very young Matt Dillon, who plays it really well as like this stoner looking guy. He's awesome in this. So basically it's just, this story of the film is following those two. trying to, you know, lose the virginity with the selected, you know, cherry poppers. It's such a horrible way of describing it. But yeah, hilarity ensues, and when usually people say that, it's like, really? But no, it's genuinely funny. The characters are great, especially the girls in this film. Usually girls aren't that funny in films, and even like female comedians, I don't tend to find them funny. It's like Christopher Hitchens said, women don't need to be funny because that's the man's job. Men use it to attract women. Women don't need to, you know, use comedy to attract men. I know that's probably going to get me into some shit for saying that. But yeah, I don't usually like, you know, female comedy characters. I mean, a recent example of a good female comedy was Bridesmaids. I really enjoyed that film. But yeah, this is a really good film. Really great performances by both the main characters and also the rest of the girls in the group. There's a lot of really, you know, smart, quick, you know, banter in there with a few great one-liners. And basically, the girls take sides on who they bet money on. And yeah, they all start to come really close as a group. So it's like a really good tale about friendship. And I suppose you can relate to a lot of these characters and the situation and, of course, the story, because, yeah, it's a big thing at that age when you want to, yeah, lose your virginity. And so you can kind of relate to them, and you feel for these characters, you laugh with them, you find them genuinely interesting and funny, and, just really well-written characters with some great performances in there. So basically, I'm not going to tell you how it all pans out. Does it work out well for them? Does it not? Does one of them, I'm not going to tell you guys what happens, but it's essentially like Meatballs, kind of, with a hint of Hard Bodies, with a smidge of films like Goonies and Stand By Me. It's a film that, even though it's rated 15, you could easily show this to someone younger than that. Because there's no real, you know, malice. It's not, you know, one of those gross-out teen comedies that relies on, you know, cum jokes and stuff like that. This is a teen movie when it's done right, because it mixes the comedy with some genuinely touching and quite sad scenes in places. I did find myself, you know, welling up at some scenes in this film as well, which just adds to why I love a film. If a film could get a reaction like that out of me or anyone, then it's doing a good job. But yeah, I've not really sold it well in this review, I know. But if you like teen comedies, if you like your humour to be a little bit, you know, more sophisticated than, you know, fuck jokes and, you know, gross out gags, like, you know, stuff like American Pie, then definitely check this film out, guys. It's just a nice, easy, feel-good film with some great characters. It's also got a great little soundtrack as well, with tracks by, you know, Blondie, Supertramp, John Lennon, to name a few. You know, great performances from Matt Dillon, Christy McNichol and Tato O'Neill, as well as, yeah, the supporting cast, the girls in the group, and the, you know, camp counsellors, and, yeah, the parents of the kids as well. So it's just a really nice little story, a real feel-good film, and it touches upon some pretty, you know, serious subjects sometimes. I mean, virginity is a big thing, and it handles it really well. There's no sleaze, there's no smut or anything like that. It's all tastefully done. But yeah, you will find yourself really enjoying this film. Like I said, if you like stuff like Meatballs and, you know, things like that, where the comedy is slightly adult but it's not too adult, and also with the aspects of, you know, the friendship and the evolution of the characters, then you will really enjoy this film. And I'm just so surprised that this film hasn't got the acclaim that it deserves, and I've never really heard people talk about it on YouTube before. I'll throw some links down below to like a trailer and some maybe clips from the film, I've also written a more informed and in-depth review on the blog with some stills from the film as well for you guys to check out if you want to. And if you guys have seen this film, let me know what you think of it. And if there are any films that focus on friendship and, you know, the good things, the positive things in life, let me know in the comments. Give me some suggestions for films like this. Check it out, guys. I go into more detail telling you about what happens and the different situations. But like the evolution of the characters, the story evolves as well. And there's, you know, lots of mixed feelings in there. Mixed emotions from the characters. And like I said, it's just a thoroughly enjoyable watch. And just a genuinely well-made film that seriously deserves a, you know, a proper release. Even if it was an on-demand release, like a Netflix release maybe as well. This is a film that definitely needs to be seen if you want to, you know, on like a Sunday afternoon, it's raining outside, you want to watch a, you know, happy, feel-good film, then definitely check this one out. I do have it, you know, a copy of it, so if anybody's interested, PM me or let me know in the comments, and I can either try and find you the link again, or I can send you a copy of it, because this is definitely a film that you guys should check out, and I'll keep repeating that because it's true. It's, you know, it's not sleazy, there's nothing, you know, too outrageous there. It's just a nice touching tale, and I just thoroughly enjoyed it from start to start to end, and I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys will as well. So like I said, guys, if you've seen the film, let me know what you guys think. If you've got any suggestions for films like that, let me know, and also check out all the links down below. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you guys are all having a great weekend, and until the next time, guys, you're all awesome.